there. So today we have assembled here to see the ligand interactions with the protein. So the easiest way to see how your ligand has interacted with your receptor in the binding site is to come to this tab which says ligand interaction, and trust me, this is the easiest one. So if you will click it, the entry which you have selected, it will appear here, and you can see it here. So now if you wish to know which color of bond represents which color, then you have to click this option which says LID legend, stands for ligand interaction diagram legend. So once you will click it, you will now read about it, and you can simultaneously write about it in your manuscript as well. So for example, this one, you will see that this ring is interacting with tryptophan 279. So this 279 is the number of amino acid. So this is tryptophan 279th position in the protein chain which we are looking at. So you will see that this ring and this amino acid are bounded by pi-pi stacking. This line and dot is pi cation bonds, and this green one, these are pi-pi stacking. So this is telling you how the ligand is placed in the in the active site of this particular receptor. If you do not want to see the three letter codes, and if you are only interested in one letter code, so what you have to do is you have to click this option, and you will see that they have now converted into one letter code. They are not now written in three letter codes, they are only in one letter code. And other than this, if you are interested in knowing whether your protein is making any hydrogen bonds with the water available, you are going to check this box. If there is anything here to report, it will come. And in case there are bonds in your active site wherein the water molecule is making bonds with the ligand, then if you will uncheck it will go away. And now this is the place wherein you can come and you can see if there are any other ligands in the protein. So if there are any other ligands in the protein other than this one, so they will appear here. For now we do not have anything, so otherwise they would have come here, and if you will select it, so the figure is going to change. So now the question is, how do I take this image for putting in my research article, right? So we are going to come to file, and then we are going to choose this option which says save screenshot. So this width and height, if I will not change it, and I'm going to keep it in the same digits, which is 661 by 946. So this image, my friends, is very, very small, and when you are going to stretch it, it is going to pixelate, and the journal might send you the image back stating that you are supposed to send us the good pixel results. So what I advise you to do is write 3000 here, and then click OK, and then it is going to save, and it is going to be saved, and then you can system, and you can open it, and you can zoom it, and you will see that it is not pixelating that much. This clarity is still fine for the manuscripts. So this is my personal experience with this. So because you have Schrodinger today, you might not have Schrodinger after some time. So make sure while you're working, just work with the right pixel image, because otherwise you'll not have it later on, and then you're going to be in trouble. So always save your pictures in good pixels. So this was how to use the ligand interaction diagram. I hope it was useful for you.